everybody, welcome back to our channel. Today we're going over synonyms and antonyms, and then we're going to do a quick little activity and scavenger hunt with synonyms and antonyms. So first off, a synonym is a word that means the same as the other, and an antonym is a word that means the opposite of the other. So a synonym and antonyms, they go hand in hand, but they are the opposite of each other, and they could change the meaning of your sentence, or they can enhance your sentence. So why are they important? So synonyms are very important because they enhance your vocabulary and it helps you have a wider range of words in your vocabulary palette. So by doing that, I'm gonna show you guys how with synonyms you can change your sentence meaning, and with antonyms you can also change your sentence into a whole complete different meaning. So you see how this sentence says, "I am going to the store." So we're gonna find a synonym for going, and I'm going to show you guys how a synonym can make the sentence sound different, but it still means the same thing. So I am going to the store. So let's see, let's think of a synonym for going. There's leaving to the store, or there's also arriving. So you can say, I am arriving to the store. So that's an example of a synonym and how your sentence can change just by changing the word, but it still has the same meaning because synonyms have the same meanings as other words. And then we have, I am eating food. So with this, we're gonna change eating to an antonym. So eating would be drinking, because drinking is the opposite of eating. So we're gonna change food to juice so that it makes sense, because you can't drink food. And then we have Woody loves bus. So we have this word here, and we wanna change the synonym, or the word here, to a different synonym. So Woody loves bus. Another word could be Woody admires Buzz. So you guys can write this down so you guys have different vocabulary words to practice spelling and also finding like the exact definition, because even though they mean the same thing, they can have a bit of a different definition for synonyms, but they have like the same interpretation. So we have Nemo found his dad. So we're gonna change found to an antonym. So that would be Nemo lost his dad. And then now we have Cinderella lived a difficult life. So we wanna change this to a synonym. So we can say Cinderella lived a uneasy life. So that's a synonym. And then now we have the night was very cold. So we wanna change cold to an antonym. So remember, we would be using the opposite. So we would do the night was very cold. So these are examples of synonyms and how your sentences can either change or they could sound different but still mean the same thing. So now what we're gonna do is a scavenger hunt. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4 adjectives here, and what we're gonna do is we're gonna find the opposite of the adjective that we have. So we have the adjective here, which is smooth. So we're gonna find the antonym of smooth, and we're gonna find that, but we're gonna change it first. So smooth can be rough. So let's find something rough, or the opposite of smooth. So let's see, we have laptops here, they're kind of smooth. We have scissors, they're pretty smooth. We have a smooth desk. Let's see, what could be rough? Oh, we have a keyboard here. You touch it and it's kind of rough. So this would be a finding of the antonym of smooth, because this is kind of rough, which is the antonym of smooth. So now our next word is small. So we gotta find something that is the antonym of small. So I'm not gonna give you guys the word this time, so I'm just gonna find it, and then you guys are gonna think of it, and then I'll tell you guys after. So small. So this is pretty small, so we wouldn't be able to use this because we're finding the antonym. So what about this? This is pretty big, So this would count as the antonym of small because, like I said, we're finding the opposite. So this chair, this seating, would be our finding because it's pretty big. Okay, so now for our next one is long. So we gotta find the antonym of long. So let's see. What about this? Because this is pretty short. So we found long because this is short. So this is the antonym of long because it's short and small. So now we have bright. So now we need to find the antonym of bright. So although I'm looking around, you guys can find different items in your house so you guys can follow along with me. So let's see. This is clear, so this is pretty bright. What about this? This table is black, so it's pretty dull. So that would count because we're looking for the antonym of bright. So we have our table, and we found our book, and then we found the chair, and then we found the keyboard because we're finding the antonyms. So you guys can comment down below things that you found, and please give a huge thumbs up and tune into our next video. Bye, guys!